In this video, I'm going to show you how to blitz using match coverage behind your pressure and the best way to go about that in Madden 22. Now, if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. I upload new videos every single day that can help you become a better Madden player. And in this video, we are actually in the Baltimore Ravens defense playbook. We'll be focusing in on the nickel triple. Now, I've been doing a lot of videos on this nickel triple formation. It's because I love it. It really is one of my favorite sets in this game. And the reason I like it so much is because there's so much you can do with this formation. It's got a lot of really interesting little kind of nuances and packages built within it that make it really, really effective. And if you want to learn exactly how I recommend that you would run the nickel triple defense, I would really encourage you to join my Patreon. By joining the Patreon, you're going to get access to every ebook that I've released so far in the Madden 22 season and every ebook that I will release while your subscription's active. You can, it's a month-to-month deal. It's only 10 bucks a month. And again, you don't have to re-up every month. You can cancel or whatever, whenever you want. But the point is, you get access to all the ebooks. All the ebooks, all the tips, all the exclusive pro player film breakdowns are all in there, including my nickel triple defense. And so if you want to really learn how the full system works, I would encourage you to join the Patreon. There's a link in the description if you would like to. But in this video, we're going to be talking about a subject that is essentially blitzing out of match defense. And I think the best match coverage that you can blitz from in this game is the cover six. And the reason why is because the cover six already kind of has a built-in way to get pressure in a very simple way. So we're just going to come out in cover six. And what you're going to notice and what makes match defense so good, specifically against bunch or bunch tight end, is the fact that we get the box check to the bunch side or to the trips, meaning that we're going to be able to have a significant amount of success basically just defending corner routes. So this very popular route combination, you've probably seen this before. For the most part, just by stock kind of the box check, you're going to be able to guard it. As you can see, I can guard every corner route to that side. And what it does is it allows me as a user to be able to kind of focus my attention back to the solo receiver or to the middle of the field or on any kind of crossing route. You know, the really cool part too is that this cover six defense, if you really dive into it, it does a pretty good job defending a little bit of everything that bunch has to offer. And so but the problem is it's a four down lineman rush, and if you take one player off the field to blitz them, sometimes you might take the wrong player. For example, let's go back to that Z spot type of concept. And if I were to blitz the nickel corner, which is one of the most popular ways to blitz in Madden, what you'll see here is we're actually running into a little bit of an issue because now we don't have a flat defender, and it's really easy for the offense to be able to basically dot us up. This is why, and the same is kind of true to the backside, right? If I were in a traditional quarter style defense, it would look something like this. So if I go to blitz this guy, now there's no underneath defender. So if they're just going to sit there and throw flats all day on you unless you know, kind of have a plan. That's why I like cover six so much, because of the ability that we have within it to protect ourselves from flats and flooding combinations, and at the same time force them to have to throw the ball over the middle of the field, which is where our user is going to be. So the setup for this blitz, I have two blitzes I want to share with you today. The first one is really simple, and then the second one is a little bit more complicated, but I think it's a little bit better for Gun Bunch and what Gun Bunch does well. So all we're going to do out of this cover six is we're going to press our coverage, we're going to globally blitz our linebacker, so you see here this is what that looks like, and then we're just going to stand kind of right over this gap, and what I like to do is take the corner on the left side and put him into a hard flat. The reason is so that if the running back goes out on a quick flat route, as you can see right here, I've got that, and as you can see, I get my A-gap pressure, and pretty much everything was bagged in that situation. That's a great blitz for five man. And basically what we're doing is we're just blitzing these yellow zone defenders. And the cool part about this is if you wanted to, you actually don't have to turn your three rec off. So you could literally just blitz this linebacker on the left side. The reason you might want to do that is because you'll find that it does help the coverage kind of stay a little bit more kind of the basic way that it would work. It does work significantly better. So again, just simply blitz that linebacker on the left side of the screen, and then you're just going to kind of hover there, and at the snap of the ball, you're either going to get edge pressure or you're going to get A-gap pressure. Now, the second setup is really good if they want to try to block their tight end or block their running back out of cover six. And what we're going to do whenever they start to do stuff like that is, and this is how I like to do it, I like to show blitz. But then really important, I'm going to bring this guy over the box, and then I'm going to grab onto this guy right here. I'm going to blitz him. I'm going to bring him in. And then as soon as I get him in, I'm going to go ahead and repress my coverage because it will help with alignment significantly. So now you see we're kind of left with this box check to the right, but we're actually kind of have a little bit of a dangerous combination to the backside. So what we're going to do here is we're going to man up that solo receiver on that solo corner on the solo receiver. We're going to man up the linebacker on the running back, and then we're actually going to stand kind of right in here, and we're going to kind of open up into the bunch side now as our three-rag hook defender. If you wanted to, you could put one of the linemen on the right side into a three-rag hook, but this to me is very effective. It's very effective for a lot of situations. What you're going to see here is we're going to get pressure right off that right edge, and we still basically have this box check to the bunch side. Now, what you really have to pay attention to is the flats to the left. So you see we don't have a flat defender over here. So if we get a drag, that's our responsibility. There's no one guarding this drag. So right there, I need to go with that drag. But as you can see, this blitz comes in really, really quickly. Okay? So let me show you this concept again. Show blitz. You're going to blitz this safety right here. And then I would just move him in like that. And then from there, just feel free to press. If you want to bring this guy down, you certainly can. You don't have to. Okay, you don't have to, but if you want to, I find bringing this guy down does sometimes help the coverage. And then you want to make sure that you man up there. Now, you don't have to put that defender on the left and man coverage on the running back. It does help if he blocks. But what you could also do is you could put him in a curl flat or a hard flat. That's completely up to you, whatever you do with him. I will say that if the running back blocks, though, it is much better if you do something like this. So now what you're going to see is we're going to block the running back, and you see that the pressure still comes completely free, and it comes in relatively quickly against a blocked running back. The cool part about this and how this all shapes up for us defensively is we're able to still keep our match rules, right? We're able to still basically, by and large, keep everything the same from a defensive standpoint, right? You don't have to move that safety down. I just think it does help. But then if they block their tight end here, what you're going to notice is we've got to get out. You see we got man coverage on that back. And then as you can see, we're still getting pressure, only sitting five. So this is a great little defense against the bunch. The easier version is to just globally blitz your your linebackers, and then you stand right here, or just simply put that guy in a three rep, or just blitz that one blacker, and as you can see, you're getting A-gap pressure. So the bottom line, guys, is cover six is the best defense in the game. I've studied every coverage in this game extensively, and I really do feel like at this point it's very fair to say that cover six is probably the best coverage in this game by and far. But the beauty of this is not just that it's a great coverage, but it can also give you the tools and the resources that you need to be able to send really, really significant pressure at your quarterback. So if you want to learn my entire nickel triple defense, or if you want to just get better, you want to get all of my ebooks, join the Patreon. Again, it's a great resource, literally has everything in there that you need to be successful in this game. So if you want to sign up for the Patreon, remember, you're going to get access to 13 offensive and defensive ebooks just by signing up for it. So again, it's just 10 bucks a month. And you can cancel whenever you'd like. There's a link in the description. If you want to check out the Patreon, head on down to the description, click the link that I put down there for you, and go check it out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.